stress and all that kind of stuff. And as you go through those things, you either going to get right, you either going to be cleansed of all that kind of stuff, or you're going to fall away. You're going to have to go. You're not going to be able to stand the fire. And so this is what they're praying for us to happen. See, because as we go back again and look at the early church and see these things, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the return of the Son of Man. Well, as it was then, so it's going to be spreading this gospel out. And those people back in that time in the first and second and third centuries, them people, they was Baptists. They really believed in God. Whenever they was going to throw them to the lions, they didn't try to draw straws and fight and see who wasn't going to go out there. They was fighting to see who was going to go out there, which one is going to be first. And the people saw them and said, hey, they really believe this. They really believe that this Jesus, he died and he rose again. And he's in heaven, and if they die, they're going to go up there and be with him forevermore. They really believe it. Because if they didn't believe it, they wouldn't be willing to die for it. See, and that's the problem now. If folk look at us and see that we ain't willing to die. I'm not talking about going out there and putting your head on the chopping block. I'm talking about living your life as a living sacrifice and taking those things in your life that God had told you to get rid of and putting them up on the altar and leaving them over there. That's what I'm talking about.
Amen.
See, because we all in here and we all been coming to church a long time, keeping ourselves under holiness and doing all them kind of things and going around here, but we all got stuff that God has been calling us to give up. Well, nothing got quiet. Amen. See, one day it's just going to be time to just go ahead and give it up. One day it's just going to be time. I'm just tired of fighting this. I'm tired of the Lord talking to me about this. I'm tired of the Lord stirring on me in the middle of the night about this. I'm tired of every time I start trying to pray about something that God keeps bringing this up into my face and keeps bringing this before me, and I don't want to be, I'm just going to quit, I got to quit praying about it because I don't want to get this right, and I know if I don't get this right, I can't ask him for this over here. Hello, somebody? See, sin separates you from God. God ain't trying to push you away, but that sin that you keep letting dwell in your heart and you don't want to get rid of is keeping you from being in relationship, and you have not because you ask not. And then when you do ask, you ask amiss and won't spend it on your own love. Yeah, that's what the Word says. That's just what the Word says. And so if you would just get that thing, see, if you'd abide in me and my Word would abide in you, you'd ask whatever, and I did, God would do it for you. So then we start looking, well, how come this stuff ain't happening in my life? Well, because you ain't abiding in the vine and the Word ain't abiding in you. And when it comes around to try to get you to move out of it, well, you're going to do it tomorrow. I'm going to put that off to tomorrow. Next week, I'm going to quit doing it. I'm just going to see, baby, you got to one day say, I'm just not going to do it no more. I don't care what it costs. I don't care how bad it hurts. I don't care how scared I am or how this situation's going to turn out. One day you're just going to have to set sail and get to stepping. Because you ain't never going to get there if you don't ever get up and get to going. Never. You'll never get there. God ain't going to come grab you up out of hair like he did in the Bible and pick you up and carry you somewhere. The Holy Ghost ain't going to grab you by the hair and throw you out there and tell you to get to walking. Now he might press and press and press on you. He might put you down in the Garden of Gethsemane and start pressing that oil up out of you. But he ain't going to make you do nothing. The Holy Ghost is a gentleman. You got to whosoever will. You got to come drink freely of the waters of life. He ain't going to take you and just put your head down in the water. So we got to get to that place that God is trying to bring us to. You can't be sitting around arrogant and saying, I don't know, I'm already there. I know enough. I done got enough. I know I got all, my whole life is a mess. I had a cousin that called my mom today. Thank the Lord that she didn't call me because I didn't want to talk to her. Spirit filled. Been in church all her life. Ain't nothing but turmoil all the time. I mean, it's always something. This one's hurt. That one's over here. Had this happen. And this happened over here. I can't get a job. These people over here against me. And I mean, it just goes on and on and on and on. I tell you what, I'm tired of all that mess. When I was out there in the world, my life was turmoil like that all the time. And I was always trying to worry about how I was going to get my next fix or how I was going to keep the police from coming over here and getting me and how I was God's going to do this over here, and what lie's going to tell this one over here. And it just went on and on and on and on. See, it got to a point I was just hooked on chaos all the time. I just wanted something to be stirred up all the time. Because if it was stirred up all the time, guess what I wouldn't have to look at? That's right. I mean, we sit around and say, there's nothing to do. I'm just going to get up and do something even if it's wrong. I know how this is going to turn out. It's going to turn out bad for me. I'm talking to somebody right now. I feel the Holy Ghost. I'm just going to get out there and do something. I don't care what it is, because I just can't stand being with my own self. I just can't stand me. I just can't stand all the stuff that I do all the time. I can't stand who I am down inside. And so I'm just going to get up and do something, even if it brings consequences, even if it ends my marriage or my relationship, or I got to go to jail or all that. It don't matter what it is, I'm just going to do it. Because I hate myself so much down inside that I'm going to have to do something. I know ain't nobody else been here and done that, but I've been there and done that. But see, you don't have to live like that no more.
No.
You don't have to be like that no more. Jesus can move on in and clean all that mess on out, and then you can be a child of the Most High God.
Right.
He can clean that right on out. You don't have to stay in it. That's what we're going to get to over there when we get into Romans the 7th chapter. See, Paul said, we see Paul talk about, well, I did the things I didn't want to do, and I didn't do the things that I wanted to do, and he went back and forth, and who's going to deliver me from this body of sin? And then folks, stop right there. I just caught in it. I can't get out of it. God knows. I don't want to do this, but I keep on doing it. And I want to do these good works for God, but I can't do them. No, you got to keep on reading. There ain't that. And when it wrote the letter, it wasn't 7 to 8. It didn't stop at the end of 7. It kept on going.
Amen.
He said, I thank the Lord for Jesus Christ. And there's now therefore no more condemnation than them in Christ Jesus that walk after the Spirit and not after the flesh. And we're going to learn about that there's laws that go down just like there's a law of gravity. There's some laws in the Spirit. And if you sow to the flesh, you're going to sow to death. But if you sow to the Spirit, you're going to sow to life. Jesus came that you might have life and might have it more abundantly. It says you might have it. It don't say you will have it. You can be born again and not have an abundant life at all. Mm-hmm. He ain't going to force it on you. It's how you're going to live. See, you can be born again, be caught up in all kind of mess. And see, we sit around, well, God, this is going to happen. I'll sit around in my mind and sit up somewhere thinking about how God, because I got things that I want in my life. I don't know about you, but I got things that I think I need, and if I don't get them, I probably ain't going to be able to make it. I have these things, and so I start sitting around and start thinking about, well, God is going to have to do this over here, and he's got to move this person over here, and he's got to touch this thing over here. Well, he probably won't be able to work this out over here, because this ain't going to get no better. And just keep going down the line, sitting in the place of God.